This last February, I posted a video about red blood cells and the heart. It was a short little clip that followed several blood cells as they went through the heart, got oxygen, and delivered it to the rest of the body.
I'm so blue when I don't have O2.
It's time to go to the heart!
And right after I posted it, one of my patrons replied that she thought I might like to know that human blood was never blue. Now, before we go further, I want you to consider what you believe about blood and why. Is blood always red? Is it red when it has oxygen, but blue when it doesn't have oxygen? What evidence do you have to support your opinion? Pause the video for a moment and consider what you believe and why. And now I'll tell you why I thought blood was blue. When I was a kid, several adults told me that blood was blue without oxygen. I remember a teacher in elementary school saying that if you were bleeding in outer space, your blood would be blue because there wouldn't be any oxygen. Turns out, there are a lot of problems with this picture. First, liquid water doesn't stay liquid in outer space. The molecules spread out and scatter into a vapor. And second, outer space is a really hostile environment because there is no atmosphere, which means there's nothing to breathe. Without the protection of a spacesuit or a spaceship, your saliva would boil off your tongue within seconds. And if you held your breath in outer space, your lungs would explode. It's also a place of extreme temperatures where it's hot enough to cook something in the sunlight and can be as cold as negative 400 degrees in the shade. Because of all of this, bleeding is very problematic. If you have a hole in your spacesuit, you'll pass out within seconds. They could put up a sign saying, "Welcome to outer space," the only place where you can die instantly from a paper cut. Aside from those issues, the idea of bleeding blue in outer space is super catchy, and I remembered it. And as I grew up, certain things seemed to confirm the idea that blood was blue. I could see my veins, which had a bluish tint to them. I learned that if someone was hypoxic and lacking oxygen, their lips and the beds of their nails would turn bluish. And I saw that babies, if they were born not breathing well, had a dusky or a bluish tint to their skin. And there were those illustrations in anatomy and physiology textbooks. Venous flow was always blue, and arterial flow was always red. All of these things supported the idea that blood was blue when it didn't have oxygen. But several times, I was exposed to a powerful counterexample. When I had blood drawn, it went into a small vial that didn't have any oxygen inside it. And the blood that went directly from my veins into this vial was not blue, it was a dark red. Now, I knew that the vial was vacuumed and had no oxygen, and I knew that the color was dark red. But here's the amazing thing, I did not even notice the contradiction. This is called confirmation bias. When you have an opinion or belief, a lot of times your brain will ignore contradicting evidence. But not consciously. I didn't look at this counterexample and think, "That's strange, I've decided I'm going to ignore it." It was a subconscious decision that I didn't even realize I had made. So I thought blood was blue when it didn't have oxygen, right up until one of my patrons made that comment on the Valentine's video. It made me wonder, how many other people thought that blood was blue? How widespread was this misconception? So I carried my camera around with me for several weeks and I interviewed as many people as I could. This was a non-scientific, non-random survey, but the results that I got looked something like this.
And I don't know why they're called red, because isn't your blood blue when it's in your veins?
They're still red.
Blue. I'm making that decision based on the fact that they look bluish, the veins do. Although I will say I took my daughter to get her blood drawn the other day, and I was told it's just a very, very dark red. But I had never known that before that other day.
So what color is blood without oxygen?
Blue.
Purple-ish, blue. As a surgeon, I know a venous blood is dark brown, and it's bright red when it is arterial blood. So I've cut this, I've seen it, I've touched it.
But it would never be blue.
Never blue.
Red blood cells, when they're not oxygenated, appear to be a bluish color.
Blue.
Maroon.
I think that I'm supposed to say blue, but I don't know if that's right.
So I felt like for a long time I believed it was blue, and then recently I came across some information that contradicted that. So I'm gonna go with red, only because I read the like headline and I was like, dang it, I was wrong this whole time. But up until then I was like, it's definitely blue.
blood is blue when it doesn't have oxygen. Isn't that the case? Is that a lie? Is that a myth? Is that just a thing people think?
Which question is a trick?
What color are red blood cells when they don't have oxygen?
No, I feel like this is a trick question too.
Yeah. They're black. They're like dark. I mean, that's just when they're dead and used up.
I mean, does oxygen doesn't change the color, does it? Well, can't it just be red? That's going to be my guess. My guess is that it's actually just red no matter what.
Almost half of the people I interviewed thought that blood was blue, but I also had answers ranging from black to white to brown to purple. I got a huge variety of answers everywhere I went except for one place. At United Blood Services, every single phlebotomist there said that blood without oxygen was dark red or maroon.
Phlebotomists work with blood every day, so their opinion has quite a bit of validity when it comes to what color blood is. Here you can see venous blood that has come directly from a vein and gone into a vacuumed vial that had no oxygen. The blood in the collection bag is quite dark in color, but if you look up where the air bubble is, you can see that the blood has a reddish hue. Maroon and burgundy are good descriptions for this color. I felt like this was good evidence and that I would be able to convince everybody that blood was not blue. But when I started sharing what I learned, a lot of people told me they still thought blood was blue.
I still think they're bluish.
Blue.
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 Huh. There was a whole set of people who were absolutely convinced that blood was blue. And at the other end of the spectrum, several people I interviewed could not believe that anyone would consider blood to be blue.
Blue? That's ridiculous!
I wasn't the only one to notice that people were really reluctant to change their minds about this. Here's what a college instructor said when I asked him how many people thought blood was blue.
When I teach my EMT classes, I would think not half, but very close to half are absolutely certain that it's blue. Absolutely certain. Convinced.
And when you tell them it's not blue, do they believe you or?
No, of course not. You could even take the blood out of their body and they could look at it and say, nope, it's definitely blue. Yeah.
So they just think it looks red because it's not, it has oxygen. But if you could get it with no oxygen, it would be blue?
That's what they think. Yeah, absolutely. They're convinced of that.
But blood is not blue. No.
At no point is it blue.
Before you find fault with one perception or another, let's acknowledge that color is complicated. It's entirely possible for people to see different colors while looking at the same thing.
What we see is a combination of the light entering our eyes and how our brain interprets that light. Let me show you with a quick example. Here is a picture of a red apple and a yellow banana taken under white light. Here's the same drawing again, but this time the photo was taken under a red light. And the question is, what color is the banana? Almost everyone still sees the banana as yellow, and if asked to match the banana with the closest color, they will choose the yellow rectangle. And they're wrong. The banana is red. If you don't believe me, watch closely while we zoom in, and you can see that the color of the banana exactly matches the red rectangle. If you still don't believe me, look at the red rectangle. It's actually a cropped picture of the exact banana you were looking at in the previous photo. The banana is red, but because of the surroundings, the redder apple and the pinkish background, our brains perceive the banana as being yellow.
Hemoglobin is the reason that our blood appears red. It's the delivery system that carries oxygen throughout the body.
I use iron to carry oxygen.
It's a very small molecule that is abundant and has incredible chemistry.
My favorite number is 4. 4 oxygens, 4 subunits, forever awesome, that's me!
Red blood cells are absolutely packed with hemoglobin. Just one cell has about 250 million hemoglobin molecules. And there is a color change in hemoglobin based on whether or not it has oxygen.
Another cool thing about us, we can change color! Yeah!
When it has oxygen, hemoglobin is red. And when it doesn't have oxygen, it's a deeper, darker red. The color does not shift all the way past orange, yellow, and green, and into blue light. The color shift is in the red spectrum. The blood in our arteries is saturated with oxygen, and the blood in our veins has about 50 to 60% oxygen saturation.
Hey, blood's not blue. What other color would you use? Green? Yellow? Different shades of red? Blue looks way better.
I suppose the convention of labeling venous flow blue is here to stay. But what about blood that doesn't have any oxygen? What color would it be? It's not easy to get blood completely devoid of oxygen, but if you do manage to remove all of the oxygen, the color turns so dark that it looks brown or black. The less oxygen you have, the darker the color will be.
So this is a really interesting question. Something that almost everybody agrees is a dark red, maroon, burgundy color looks bluish under certain conditions. If you look at the palm of your hand, you should be able to see just a couple little blue veins there, regardless of your skin pigment. And then, of course, some people who are very fair-skinned can see veins all over their body. I found a great answer in a peer-reviewed scientific journal called Applied Optics. In this article, the researchers went into a great amount of detail. They talked about photons, the particles that make up light, and why we perceive colors the way we do. And it was full of lovely sentences that sound intelligent but are difficult to understand, such as, "The photons are incident perpendicular to the optically turbid medium."
Huh?
The language might have been difficult, but the experiment itself was really interesting. In the article, researchers described how they had tubes of venous blood to represent veins, and then tubes of blood that had 100% oxygen to represent arteries. They put both of these tubes underneath a translucent barrier that was meant to mimic skin, and then they measured the light. And they found that both a vein or an artery will appear blue or turquoise when they are of a certain size and at a certain depth underneath the skin.
But if the tubes were smaller than a certain diameter or too deep, they would not appear blue.
So this is really cool. If your arteries were close to the surface and big enough, they would look blue too. But your body has a practical design. Arteries are deep inside you and veins are close to the surface because if you cut a vein, you can fix it with a Band-Aid. Whereas if you cut an artery, you need a tourniquet and maybe surgery. It's pretty cool to know that both arteries and veins would look blue under the right conditions, but where does the blue color come from in the first place? Well, remember that white light is made up of all the wavelengths of color. And when light hits an object, certain wavelengths are absorbed and certain wavelengths are reflected back out.
A red apple reflects more red light, and that's why it appears red to us when we look at it.
There's more of it, so that's what you see.
The reason veins can appear blue is because the tissue absorbs more red light, and so the light that's reflected back out has a larger percentage of blue.
Again, this is something that only works if the skin is a certain pigment, and the vein is a certain diameter, and it's within a certain distance from the surface. In a way, it's kind of like our banana example, where the surroundings are causing a perceived color. Does this mean that you'll never find blue blood? No.
Several animals have blue blood, including Armadillidium vulgare, the potato bug, spiders, octopus, squid, and mollusks. And their blood is blue because they don't use hemoglobin to carry oxygen. They use hemocyanin, which contains copper instead of iron as a binding agent. So there is such a thing as blue blood, but for humans and every other vertebrate, blood is always red.
If you enjoyed this video, please share it and subscribe. As always, work hard, grow smart, and I'll see you next time.
Brown.
Red.
Blue.
Would it ever turn blue?
No. Unless you like dyed it with something. Your veins are like stained glass windows.
This is why I kick people.